Loving. Do you believe there's such a thing as soulmates? I find it makes sense. What's really true here? What matters?
Happy birthday, sweetheart.
You promised.
What I promised was not to sing. In frosting, your all-time favorite.
Oh. You get so weird with this cake thing.
It's tradition. Come on now, don't give me a hard time.
You know, if I'm getting older, that means you're getting older too.
I am not. After a while, you don't. Nobody has a clue how old I am.
Well, I do.
You just think you do. Oh, I made his lunch reservations at Anton's.
I can't, I'll be in court.
Iggy. Does Judge Sorensen know it's your birthday? Oh, then I'll make dinner reservations.
I told you I'm going to the apartment tonight.
It just seems so wasteful when you have an entire house.
This is your house.
Silly, it's ours. And furniture. You have no furniture.
Oh, it doesn't matter. I'll just throw a mattress on the floor for a while.
Look, I understand this is something you feel you have to do, but I wanted us to celebrate your birthday. The apartment isn't going anywhere.
You know it's time I did this.
I know.
I'm just trying to do the right thing.
I know you are, and I want you to. It's natural. It's the way it's supposed to be. What time are you in court today?
11.
Surely you'll break for lunch.
Okay.
I love you.
I said okay.
Oh, we'll go to Anton's and we'll have Dom Perignon. And to hell with that grand. Good morning.
Good morning.
Those interrogatories.
Oh, great. Thank you.
Happy birthday.
I didn't know anybody knew.
Yeah, well, I knew.
Well, thank you very much.
Well, I was wondering if you'd care to have lunch with me. Actually, I'd like to take you to lunch for your birthday.
I'm sorry, I already had plans. But that's very nice of you.
Well, maybe another time.
Hey, Nick, did you get the apartment?
Yes, I did. I'm going to look at it tonight.
Oh, you have a new place?
Well, I tried to get him to come share mine, but he didn't like the color scheme. My alimony is just killing me.
I'll see you later.
Bye.
Say, I'll go with you. See the apartment later? I'd like to see it.
Oh, yeah, great. Let's go after work.
Great. Later.
Something wrong?
Nikki, Nikki's in trouble.
Oh, what kind of trouble?
Oh, credit cards. I don't know, but he's in deep. I've got to get my hands on some cash real quick, or I don't know what will happen to him.
Well, sure, Nick will find a way. He's so smart.
Oh, he is. He is. But this time, I may just be overly concerned. But this time, I don't know. Jane, dear, I'm sorry. I don't mean to come up here and unload my problems on you.
Oh, no, you haven't.
It's just that since Nikki and I have lived here, well, you know how we've looked out for each other. And, well, your family, there's just no other word for it.
I feel the same.
You're like my mother.
Oh, here. You take this. I want to loan you this.
Your dividend check, Jane.
I want to. But you have to pay it back. Well, of course you'll pay me back.
You are just the sweetest.
Oh.
Oh.
So in other words, Mr. Lance, you were not in the Market Street alley at the time of the robbery.
That's correct. I'd gone to the lower lot to get a customer's car, and then I had to pull it around.
And that took about how long?
Oh, a couple of minutes, no more.
So, you did not see Mr. Lopez in the vicinity, did you?
Right. I did not, no.
Thank you, Mr. Lance. That's all.
You can step down. Counselor, you and Mr. Singh approach. Mr. Donahue, are you going to call any other witnesses?
No, Your Honor.
Mr. Donahue, you have yet to establish an alibi for your client.
Your Honor, if you recall in the state of Maryland versus Everett, no alibi was ever established.
Counselor, I'm impressed. You can take us through lunch and dinner, and I still won't know where you're going. I'd take the plea Mr. Singh offered today, which was what?
5 to 10, Your Honor.
Your Honor, the state has not presented one substantial piece of evidence. All right. Reduce it to receiving in exchange for the plea in 3 years in county. They're offering 3 years in county. I can't guarantee you'll get anything better.
But my husband didn't steal those things.
Look, I'm not advising you to take it, but the fact is, Umberto was in the wrong place at the wrong time, and he could end up doing 10 to 15 instead of 3.
Okay, I'll take it.
Your Honor, my client accepts the plea.
Excellent. I want all parties back here at 2 o'clock on the dot for sentencing.
You were brilliant.
I lost.
No, you compromised. Your husband didn't do anything, and you know it. You know it.
Mrs. Lopez, you knew exactly what we were up against from the beginning of this case.
No, look, I am sick of your lawyer talk. You are sending my husband to jail, and he doesn't belong there.
Go on, open it.
Oh, my. I can't believe you did this. Oh, this is incredible.
Happy birthday. I racked my brain for the right gift. I knew it would make you happy.
Can we afford this?
Of course we can afford it.
Oh, well, I love it. Thank you very, very much.
Power watch. Every rising young attorney needs one.
You go to Harris Specials.
In a moment. Would you relax and just enjoy your birthday?
You know, I'm really very excited about this apartment. I do think it's best. I just want us to be clear.
Oh, we're clear.
Well, I hope that we are. I need to be on my own.
Absolutely. I was on my own at 13. Wandering the streets, scrounging for a meal and a bed.
I know you had it rough.
You know what I've told you. The sanitized version. Yes, I had it rough. But now I have the best, the richest life a woman could hope for.
I want that too. I want what everybody else has, a family, a wife.
Wives are overrated. And you have a family.
You know what I'm talking about.
I only want what's best for you, Nikki. Someday you'll know that.
I already know that.
Someday you really will.
I guess what I'm trying to say is, I just want your blessing.
You have it. All my love. And my blessing. Now, exactly where is this apartment? I'll come over and do whatever. Mop floors. This wasn't happening until the end of the month. What happened?
The place fell through.
There'll be other apartments.
You have to let go.
What is this about? Getting your own place or getting away from me? I mean, that's what it sounds like. I'll move to the garage. Let you have the entire place to yourself.
Jane.
To hell with Jane. I'm sorry the apartment fell through, but I... You think I had something to do with this?
Of course I don't.
Then where are you going in the middle of the night like some escapee?
Brian Moffat said that I could stay with him at his place while I find some place of my own.
Nikki, my God. Why are you doing this so all of a sudden?
It's not all of a sudden.
Nikki, you can't do this to me.
Yes, I can do this. I have to. You always say how you want me to be successful, but I never will be until I'm on my own. I'm a grown man. God, you're making it sound like we're breaking up. You're my mother.
Thank you. Nick Donahue?
Is she all right?
She's fine. I'm Abby Fletcher. You okay? You sure? Did you ever do this before?
I upset her. I pushed too far this time. I don't know.
It's okay. You don't have to explain. Has she ever talked to someone?
Me? She talks to me?
No, I mean a counselor or a therapist.
You don't know my mother. Nobody understands her like I do. Nobody gets it when she does things like this. She just ends up hurting herself.
It's okay if you want to go in and see her now.
You know that I love you. Why would you do a thing like that?
I never meant to. Oh. My poor, poor darling. Of course I want you to spread your wings. You know that, don't you? Birthday. Wanna make a wish?
Thanks. Tight skirts. Push-up bras, the heels, the lip gloss. Man melt. Almost every man I've ever known has tried to get me into bed, including my own father. After a while, you learn to use that power for yourself. Many sides. Many, many identities. Friend, I hope. Lover. But no, never a criminal. Nothing ever worked in my life. Except one thing.
Oh, what a nice surprise. Hey, it's okay. It's not like we're a secret anymore. Look at you. Look how handsome you look.
You look very nice.
Listen, give me 10 more minutes and I'm off duty.
Oh, you are?
You know my schedule by now. Want to go to lunch?
That would be great.
Want to go to my place?
You forgot. We were on for lunch.
What are you talking about? We didn't make any plans.
We had a date, and you forgot.
Oh, stop saying that. I would never forget a lunch date with you.
Okay, then. You didn't remember. I smell passion. Perfume. Who's the lucky gal? I'm not interested in playing games with you. I'll see you at home this evening.
Hello?
I can't believe you just did that.
Don't worry, I hung it up.
All right, Mother, look, I've met someone. We've gone out a few times. What's so wrong with that?
No, I'm thrilled you met someone you like.
Then why this?
Sweetheart, I know girls like this.
You don't know Abby.
Do you?
I think I do.
Girls like this will give you the ride of your life. The next thing you know, they're pregnant.
She's on the pill.
Do you have to throw it in my face?
Well, you brought it up. She is.
She says she is. I just don't want to see her use you or hurt you.
I'm a big boy, Mother. This is not a conversation I want to be having with you.
Why not me? It should be me more than anybody. Nikki?
I'm not making excuses for what she did. I'm not. She's always done weird stuff. She's ranted and raved. But she doesn't mean anything by it. You can't take it personally. We're best friends. I'm all she has.
Please. That is so unbelievably untrue. I'm sorry, but it is.
What?
She's convinced you that it's just the two of you. And if she's convinced you, then it probably is that way. Nick, I love you, but I don't know how to compete.
Abby, there's no competition here.
Anyway, I wouldn't dream of doing anything to come between you two.
I've waited for somebody like you my whole life. I have.
I'm Abby Fletcher. I'm a nurse at Smithfield Hospital.
My angel of mercy. Come in.
What a beautiful room.
Thank you.
It's always changing. I'm always adding something or moving something.
In that way. Do you always make follow-up visits to your patients?
Oh, no, never. I just thought we ought to talk. About Nick.
Nikki. Yes.
I just thought that it would be easier.
If you and I were friends.
Yes.
I can see why Nikki is so taken with you.
Parents were killed in a car crash when she was 16. Put herself through school. She was more or less on her own. She moved out here about a year ago from the West Coast. I gotta tell you, Abigail Fletcher is about as clean as they come. She pays her bills, her taxes, she votes, she even returns her library books on time. Looks like your son found himself a terrific girl.
Yes, it does.
How about a glass of wine?
Oh, I can't. I've got to get going.
Keeps you on a tight leash, doesn't she?
Now, you know I see her on Saturdays.
Such a schedule. I suppose that's good. A little dull. You're getting serious about this girl, aren't you?
Slightly.
I mean, marriage serious. Have you talked about it yet?
Not yet, no. Now you're rushing to marry me off?
Not exactly. I'm afraid there's something you better look at.
I'm late, I'll look at it later. What is it?
I'd rather not be the villain. I'd rather you saw it with your own eyes.
Where did you get these?
Honey, I think you should at least take the time to read.
I asked you where the hell this came from.
From an investigator. Nikki, don't be mad. I couldn't help it. I had this feeling. Honey, I couldn't stand by and watch you get hurt. Petty theft, prostitution. The man, she blackmailed into marrying her by claiming she was pregnant.
I don't know where that came from, but none of it is true.
Nikki, it's in black and white.
Would you stop? Just stop.
Records. I mean, you don't know why this girl picked up and moved out here.
Mother, I swear, you will do anything. You will say anything.
Well, don't take my word. Ask her.
I will. Sorry, it will never happen again. Look, Abby, I love you. And I want us to be married. Right now, tonight. No, I mean it. I don't want to take a chance of ever losing you.
What about your mother?
Just let me deal with her.
This is not exactly the way I imagined myself being proposed to.
Eddie, please. Will you marry me?
Nick, I have something to tell you. I'm pregnant. I want you to understand that you have absolutely no obligation in this. I mean it. I was gonna have this child on my own, and I will still do that.
Nicholas Taylor Donahue, do you take Abigail Emma Fletcher to be your lawfully wedded wife? to stand by her in sickness and in health. For richer and for poorer.
I most certainly will.
Easy, boy, we're not there yet. To love her and cherish her until death do you part.
Nikki, I was so worried.
We came up to the lake. Are you there?
I'm here.
Did you hear what I said?
You're angry. I misbehaved. I know I did.
I'm calling because I have something to tell you. Abby and I came up here on our honeymoon. Did you hear what I said?
Yes, I heard. I heard you. I never realized.
Things will be different now.
It was that serious. I never would have. I'm really so embarrassed. But happy for you both.
Thank you, Mother. If you mean it.
Oh, Nikki. Of course I do. Of course I mean it, sweetheart.
I really have to go now.
She's there with you now? Okay, then. Love you.
Goodbye, Mother.
Love you.
On the 2nd of May, when Karen Carson accompanied Officer Travis to his motel room, she did so after spending an entire evening with him, getting to know him, or so she thought, coming to trust him. Karen Carson has a respectable career as a flight attendant. She is highly regarded and valued by her peers. She is a professional. She is not a prostitute. But now my client finds herself with some very serious charges against her. And because of mistakes that she may have made in her past, and paid for, we must be careful not to point a finger too quickly and say, guilty then, she's probably guilty now.
Very well. Thank you, Mr. Donahue. Court will reconvene in 30 minutes.
Guy you married here.
I know.
I'm sorry, Abby. I don't mean to intrude.
You're not intruding.
I just had to say something to you both, face to face. I have to apologize for that little stunt. I panicked. I did. And I... There's no excuse. I'm just very ashamed of myself. And I hope that you'll be able to forgive me.
Diana, it's forgotten.
What's done is done. Let's just move on. We'll call you.
Oh, wait! You know what? This is the first time I've seen you two together.
Baby? Oh, one shock at a time.
I have a job. For you. What's your name?
Jackson.
You reasonably sober, Jackson?
Well, yes, ma'am.
Good, let's go. It's $50. Do as I tell you, you walk away with 10 more of these. Now. We'd like to get our marriage annulled. We have the original certificate right here.
I thought that went pretty good. Hey, what about my money? Wait, you said the... Wait.
I don't care what I said. You better disappear or I'll make you wish you had. I'll make you disappear. You got that. Look at you. You look so handsome, so professional. You're wearing cufflinks.
Oh, yes, they're a present from Andy.
Nice. Nice touch. I like them.
Why don't we have something special? How about a bottle of Dom?
Yes. We'll celebrate. Oh, I found this wonderful painting for the dining room. Maybe after this we can go see it. And sure. You can give me your opinion.
Fine.
What?
Nothing. Good news.
Doesn't look so good. I can still read you like a book, you know.
Abby's pregnant. You're going to be a grandmother in October.
That's 7 months. Nikki, she trapped you.
No, she didn't. She didn't tell me she was pregnant until after I proposed.
Oh.
That's the truth.
It's my fault. I raised you to be a perfect woman.
Stop.
So now you're doing the right thing. Honey, she pulled the oldest trick in the book, and you fell for it. It's so low what she did, so deceitful.
That's it.
This is the woman you married, a lying little slut.
Hey, it says something here about fathers. Talk to other fathers about your feelings. Renew contacts with the men who participated in your childbirth class. Join fathers' groups. Will you do that?
Yeah, I guess. God, I don't know if I can do this. I feel so ill-equipped.
You're gonna be the best father. You know what? We ought to start thinking about names. What was your father's name?
I never knew my father.
Not even his name?
I didn't push him. You don't with my mother.
We are gonna have the best, most wonderfulest family in the world. I promise. Hello? Hold on a second. Jane?
Hello, Jane? Is something wrong?
She hasn't come out,
Nikki. Thank God. Diana, she drove her car into the garage 10 minutes ago.
Call 911. I'm on the way.
Your mother?
Yeah. Listen, I'll call you as soon as I get there.
Hurry back.
Thank you.
down here?
Who is it?
County police, you understand if they come get you?
Car running. Did you know you did that?
I am not changing this subject. Hardly. I know what the subject is. You ask about my past, my life, and I see something of the professional in you. I do. You're very good. That poor girl was my daughter-in-law, for heaven's sake. I would never have dreamed of harming her. You know that, don't you?
Abby? Abby!
Mr. Donahue, Charlie Gillespie, Investigator, County Police.
Detective.
Now, tell me, your wife, she ever take off like this before?
No, never. She never would have.
Hoping for a boy or a girl?
That's her magazine. I found it by the door like she dropped it.
Yeah, my wife just had a girl.
Congratulations.
Mr. Donahue, you know that she's got to be gone 24 hours before we can make out a report.
Yes, I'm aware of that. I'm an attorney, detective. But she's not just missing. She wouldn't leave without taking a jacket or putting on her shoes. Something has happened here.
You called the hospital.
Oh, maybe she got scared and went to her friends.
I've already called everybody she knows.
I'm just trying to help you.
I know. But if I hadn't had to race over to your place last night...
Don't make this my fault.
I'm sorry.
We just have to wait.
Still have no leads in their search for a Smithfield woman who mysteriously disappeared from her residence 3 nights ago. If you have seen Abigail Donahue or have any information on the whereabouts of this woman, you are asked to contact county police. In other news, there was a suspicious fire in a warehouse downtown.
Why do you ask that?
Well, I just heard you ask the bartender.
Mrs. Sweeney?
He's just a fellow. He's Billy's boyfriend.
I'm sorry. Charlie Gillespie, Investigator, County Police. I didn't mean to startle you. I just have a couple of questions. Is this an okay time?
I already talked to the police earlier.
Yeah, and there's a couple of things from earlier that just aren't exactly clear to me about that night.
I don't know what else I could add.
Now, you said you heard Mrs. Donahue drive into the garage. The engine stayed on. You heard the garage door close. And then you went down and you tried to open it?
That's right.
You told the officers that you looked out of this window, but you didn't see Mrs. Donahue go from the garage to the house.
Well, I thought she was still in the garage.
But her son found her in the bedroom. And considering the view out of this window, I can't imagine how you missed her. Unless Nick Donahue was lying. Mrs. Sweeney, you understand how serious this is.
She's gonna be so mad at me.
You made that call to Nick. She made you do it, right?
She just wanted some attention. I'm sure she didn't mean anything else. She made me. She's gonna be so mad, she's gonna kill me. She will, I know it.
No, she won't.
You don't understand.
License and registration. You know your headlights out?
I mean, no, I didn't know that.
Gonna have to ask both of you boys to step outside the car. Hands where I can see them.
You might want to close the door, Mr. Donahue.
She's dead, isn't she?
I'm sorry.
I'm so sorry.
Mrs. Donahue, I have a warrant for your arrest.
Mother, what is it?
A warrant for my arrest.
The charge is murder in the first degree. We have good reason to believe that Mrs. Donahue is involved in your wife's murder.
Oh, that's absurd. Detective, my mother may be a strong personality, but she's not capable of hurting anyone. She was in her room at the exact time Abby was taken. I know that for a fact. I saw her.
They say she hired them to do the job.
Who says? Where did my mother allegedly find people who could do something like that?
We were told the tavern out by the lake, the Camelot.
My mother has rights.
Yeah, and I read them to her. And now I'm taking her in and I'm booking her.
You said the Camelot?
That's right.
Mother, are you all right? You're going to be all right.
Why would they do this? How could they even think that I was hurt, Abby?
Don't talk to them. Don't answer their questions. Do you understand? Let me get her a coat. Don't worry. I'm going to take care of you. I promise. It's okay, Mother. Shh. It's gonna be okay.
I haven't answered any questions just like you told me, but I don't think I can do this.
You're gonna be fine. Calm down, I'm here.
I am so sorry to be putting you through all this now with everything else. Oh, sweetheart. You look so tired.
I'm fine. Really, I'm fine.
They keep asking me the same questions over and over again. I wish they'd just give me an opportunity to sit down face to face with those two losers.
The Camelot. The detective mentioned the Camelot. Umberto Lopez worked there. Do you remember, Mother? He was my client, the one who pled out.
The one with the wife?
Yes, she was furious with me for it, too.
So, what do you think it means? You think it's some kind of revenge? So they're going after me?
I don't know, but I intend to find out. I talked to Brian about representing you, Brian Moffitt.
No, why can't you?
Oh, I can't do that.
Why not?
I'm sorry, Mother, I just can't.
No, I want you to. You have to do it.
I'm not prepared, Mother. I wouldn't have the objectivity.
Of course you would. Nick, you're an attorney first, and a damn good one. Under the circumstances, as you say, there isn't a jury that wouldn't be sympathetic. That is, if you believe in what you're fighting for. Do you believe me? Do you believe I had nothing to do with this?
Of course I do.
Well, then, it's settled.
If I do this, Brian has got to be co-counsel.
Fine.
He's an excellent attorney.
Fine, that's fine. Whatever you say.
And, Mother, the only way I'll be able to help you is if you're totally truthful with me.
Nicky, always truthful
no,
with...
No, I am not taking this case unless I'm sure you can be 100% honest with me.
Nicky, my God. I know sometimes I get carried away, but this is different. I'll do whatever you say. I'll tell you everything.
This time, you absolutely have to. Mr. Pearson, do you know who I am?
Yeah. You're her kid.
I am Diana Donahue's attorney.
Okay. Okay, I get it.
What do you get?
You're defending her.
That's right.
So what do you want?
Tell me about Gloria Lopez.
What about her? She runs a Camelot.
How much money did she pay you to kill my wife?
You are whacked. You know, you're just as much of a nutcase as your mother is. That bitch sets up your wife, and now you are defending her. Man, you must have wanted to get rid of her awful bad.
You sorry son of a bitch. You killed Abby, and you're gonna pay for it. I am gonna watch you die in the gas chamber.
Give your mother a message for me, will you, counselor? If I'm going in there at 12:02, I'm gonna be laughing when she goes in there at 12:01. Seen her come in, right? And seen her go and talking to Gloria. And she tells Gloria something like that she's close to the judge. You know, the judge that put her husband away. And she says that she knows some way to get her husband released, right? So then she says she's got this job that needs to be done and needs some kind of special assistance. You know, that's when Gloria brings her over and introduces her to us. Right, she tells us she got this job, right, and all we need to do is have the guts to do it. So she says to us, she thinks she can negotiate some satisfactory terms. And she says she'd give us $3,000 to get rid of the girl.
Get rid of the girl. Did she ever make clear what getting rid of meant?
Yeah. Dead.
Did Mrs. Donahue ever mention why she wanted this girl to die?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, she did. She well, she said that her son was too good for this girl and that this girl was a whore. But, I mean, it didn't matter to us anyway, right? We weren't really going to kill this girl.
You weren't?
No. We were gonna, you know, take her down south, dump her off somewhere south of the border, and then come back, collect our dough. And by the time the girl got back, we'd be long gone.
Didn't quite work out that way, did it?
No.
In your testimony, you said it was Mrs. Lopez who sent Mrs. Donahue over to your table.
That's right.
Have you ever heard Mrs. Lopez talk about me, Nicholas Donahue?
Objection, irrelevant.
Your Honor, this will be relevant to motive. I just need to ask a few foundational questions.
Proceed.
So did you ever hear Mrs. Lopez talk about me?
I heard her cussing you out a time or two, yeah.
In regards to?
In regards to you being a cause of her old man was having to do some time.
So then, Harold put her in the back seat, and I drove away. She just looked so still back there that I got sort of scared. I kept asking, "Are you sure that she's okay?" I was worried that he'd given her too much of that ether or something. She just didn't seem okay. Then we got a little ways outside of town, and that's when she woke up.
So your little kidnapping scheme failed. So you just took your victim's life. What gives you credibility?
Say again?
Why should this court believe any of your testimony? You took another person's life. And now you're trying to blame it on my mother so you won't get the death penalty. Well, it won't work.
Excuse me, Counselor. Do you intend to question this witness?
Yes, Your Honor. I certainly do.
Well, what do you expect when they parade out these liars, these lowlifes? Could make the Virgin Mary look like a harpy. What? Tell me what you want me to say. Listen to me. This is a gross injustice. It has been so twisted, so distorted.
Dr. Sawyer, how would you describe the nature of Mrs. Donahue's relationship with her son?
Objection.
Overruled.
Your Honor.
Overruled, Mr. Moffat. Mr. Hewitt, I presume this is relevant.
Yes, Your Honor, as to establishing a motive, this line of questioning is very relevant.
Proceed, then.
Shall I repeat the question?
It's not necessary. When her son came along, it was very probably the first time Diana Donahue had experienced love. Pure love. She lost her mother at a very young age. She was trod upon by her father and by every other man she ever came into contact with. But with her son, he became everything to her. He fulfilled needs in her that were not solely maternal.
I'm not sure I understand.
He was not just her son. He was her friend, her confidant. He was all she had. With many mothers and sons, that is by no means unusual.
I see. So Abby Fletcher entering her son's life must have been yet another trauma for her.
Yes, it was.
She must have been extremely jealous of this younger woman.
This was not just simple jealousy. Her history. She has always used sex as a tool, as an implement, or a weapon, when need be.
Even with her son?
No, no. This was the one man in her life that she has not been sexual with, the one pure relationship. The idea that he could become sexual with a woman, have an intimate relationship, this infuriated her. This destroyed the purity that was between them. This turned him into a man.
And her experience had proven that all men are bad.
From her experience, yes.
And when her own son became a man, a father, she couldn't stand it.
Wouldn't stand it. Wouldn't stand it.
Mr. Hewitt?
The state would like to call Nicholas Donahue.
You're going to do great.
Mr. Donahue, directing your attention to a day a few weeks after your marriage when you met your mother for lunch at Jake's restaurant, do you recall the two of you getting into an argument at that lunch?
No.
You did not engage in any argument?
I did not engage in any argument.
Did your mother say the words, "She pulled the oldest trick in the book, and you fell for it"?
I don't recall her exact words.
Mr. Donahue, how would you describe your relationship with your mother?
We have a good relationship, a normal one. Like any mother and son.
Like any mother and son?
Yes, ups and downs, but always with a lot of love and caring.
Is it true that you lived with her up through your 29th birthday?
Yes, it is.
Is it true that she was extraordinarily possessive of you?
No, I wouldn't call it extraordinarily.
Though she did discourage you from moving out on your own.
Look,
and she did discourage you from forming relationships with other women.
We have no other family but each other.
Ah. Is that why when you moved to Chicago to attend law school, she moved up there with you? Mr. Donahue, did you date at all during the time that you were going to law school?
Yes, I had a few dates.
Really? What were some of their names?
Mr. Donahue, how many bedrooms were there in the apartment that you shared with your mother?
One. I slept on the couch.
You were in law school for 3 years. Are you telling us that for 3 years you slept on a couch?
How dare you?
Mrs. Donahue, another word
Your Honor,
from
this
you?
Man is trying to turn our relationship into something indecent.
Mrs. Donahue,
indecent.
You are in contempt.
Babe? Me and I are as close as a mother and a son can be. It is good and pure and proper.
Your Honor, I apologize to the court on behalf of my client.
Oh, then.
This court is adjourned until 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Go on. Say what you're thinking. I know what you're thinking.
No, you don't.
I always do.
No, you don't. This time you don't know.
I'll behave from now on, I promise.
I don't want you to testify.
But I have to. I have to tell my side the truth.
He will do everything he can to make you blow up.
Him? He's a toad. I'm not worried about him.
I am. About him. About what the jury will think if they see you lose your temper again.
Listen to me. I will pull this off. Don't you worry. I intend to knock him dead.
I have here, Mrs. Donahue, records that show you've been married 7 times.
Yes, I have made mistakes.
All of those marriages ended after only a few weeks. 2 of them resulted in fraud charges against you.
I have not been lucky in love. My choices is as you can see.
And the charges?
Unfounded. That should be there, too, in your report.
Losing your daughter must have been awfully difficult.
My daughter-in-law, yes. Yes, it was.
No, I'm talking about your daughter. You had a daughter, did you not? A daughter who died in infancy. How did she die?
In her sleep. She had a blood disorder that went undetected. She was 3 months old.
An awfully sad time. Was she older than your son?
She died before he was born, yes.
Before this incident, had you ever been arrested?
There was one time, yes.
When was that?
Oh, must be over 20 years ago. It was all a mistake. It was my mistake. I walked out of a department store and I forgot to pay for my purchase. It was quite embarrassing, as you can imagine.
Yes, I'm sure it was. Would you care to comment on this police report I have in front of me, filed in Chicago, which alleges you committed acts of prostitution?
There was no basis for those charges. It was thrown out of court.
Yes. Then this, an arrest for shoplifting, another 2 months later for petty theft, extortion, petty theft charges.
Mr. Hewitt?
Your Honor, I'm establishing a pattern of behavior that this woman has been able to get by with up till now. Mrs. Donahue, is it not true that you use copies of your own police record to falsify records of Abigail Fletcher Donahue?
That was a childish, immature prank, and I apologize profusely to Nick and Abby.
You sent your son through law school, correct?
Yes, sir.
Where did that money come from?
I worked. Invested.
Invested wisely, it would seem.
Yes.
It seems your pattern was to date a man, declare pregnancy, either extort money or marry, divorce him, and then demand support payments, which you then invested. Is this correct? Mrs. Donahue, please answer the question.
Yes, but you're making it sound corrupt in a way that it was not.
If I am, I certainly apologize.
Your Honor, the defense requests a recess. I would like to confer with my client.
The court will take a 15-minute recess.
You were married 7 times and you never told me? And arrested? You were arrested for prostitution?
That was thrown out. All the charges were thrown out. They were just silly, silly things I could never bring myself to tell.
You told me you were going to be honest with me and you weren't.
Nikki.
That was the deal! Why didn't you tell me I had a sister who died? And you never told me.
No, I never did. I just never did. No reason, nothing I was hiding. Nikki, it has nothing to do with my love for you.
Mr. Donahue.
We'll be right there.
Obviously, you do love your son very much.
Yes, I do. Very much.
Would you do anything for him?
Anything. Within reason.
Would you break the law for him?
Absolutely not.
I see. But you would go through a lot of trouble for him.
As any mother would, yes.
A normal loving mother?
Yes.
Then let me ask you this. Would a normal loving mother have her son's marriage annulled behind his back? Son's marriage annulled without his knowledge.
Yes, Mr. Hewitt, I did that. That's another one of my silly tantrums.
So that's how you reacted when you found out he'd gotten married. How did you react when you found out his wife was pregnant?
I was suspicious, of course.
You thought he'd been conned, tricked into marriage.
That was my first impression.
Because you yourself had done the exact same thing to so many other men.
I had been accused of it, as you pointed out.
And you wanted to protect him.
Yes, I'm sorry, Nikki. Yes, I wanted to protect you.
What really bothered you most was that she was trying to take him away from you. Is this correct?
I would never, ever harm that poor girl.
The question, Mrs. Donahue?
Yes!
And you love him better than anyone else ever can or ever will.
What's wrong with that? What is so wrong? Why does that make me guilty? That's what you're punishing me for. That is why I am on trial here. Nikki. Nikki, look at me.
Would the defendant please rise?
We, the jury, find the defendant, Diana Claire Donahue, guilty of murder in the first degree.
This court is adjourned. Bailiffs.
Process. I trust that you will weigh these points I have presented and reverse the decision for appeal.
You did the best you could.
Her life was in my hands and I failed.
Don't blame yourself.
They're going to kill my mother. The governor's my only chance. The truth is, my mother and I had an unusually close relationship. To the point of obsession at times. But I am as responsible for that as she is. I know I am. I allowed her to be protective. By not putting a stop to it, I encouraged it. There were many times I could have stopped it, but I didn't. And because I didn't, she went from protective to overprotective to the point that she would do anything to keep me close to her. I have already lost my wife and my unborn child, and my responsibility for that will haunt me the rest of my life. But for my mother to be killed in punishment, in retribution, especially when I was complicit in her sickness, would only compound this tragedy. I know she deserves to be punished, but please, I'm begging you. Please don't let her die.
All I was ever guilty of was loving. Look at me. Please. Why won't you? Why won't you now? That's all I want. That's all. If I thought you couldn't bear to look at me. If I thought you didn't believe in me.
That's not what happened. That's not all of it.
It is, Nikki. It is the end. So that's it. It really is the end.
Mother, I came here because I need you to tell me what happened, and you still haven't.
I have been.
You still haven't answered me my one question.
When you were little, you would fight for all you were worth to stay up until we finished our story. You could be so stubborn.
Mother, this is it. You have to be honest.
I told you.
There will not be another chance for you to say it.
I told you, Nikki. I told you.
You have to say it! You have to say it. You have to tell me. If I have to spend the rest of my life knowing, but not hearing it from you,
Nikki, I did. I went to that place. I hired those men. I did it. Hearing it from me helps you, and that someday you'll be able to. Have done something right.
Love you.